Good morning. I welcome you all again for the lecture on Production Technology 1-3 and the topic that we are continuously doing since last four lectures is automates, that is semi-automatic machines. We had started with semi-automatic machine, that is capstan and turret lathe. We have seen the construction, different components, difference between center lathe and capstan and turret lathe. Thereafter, we have seen difference between capstan lathe and turret lathe. Thereafter, next we have already done with tool holding devices and work holding devices. Various tool holding devices that are used in this machine are collets, pneumatic chuck, and certain automatic chucks which can clamp the part without human intervention. We have seen two mechanisms. One is bar feed mechanism and another is the tool automatic changeover mechanism, that is called turret mechanism. Hexagonal turret is used, and the mechanism behind the auto indexing of hexagonal turret is called Geneva mechanism. So we have also discussed one example as to how tools are planned for different operations, and that is called as tool sequencing. Total 8 tools can be used at a time on this machine. Maximum capability of holding the tools are 6 plus 4 plus 4, that is nearly 16 tools. But at a time in one setup, it is normally used as 6 plus 2, 8 tools setup. So in most of the cases, the small components that are to be manufactured are completely machined using these 8 tools. In case we need more tools, we need to use special fixtures in the turret or in the cross slide front and rear end tool attachment systems. So now, as we had discussed earlier, this is the component that is to be machined, and the auto bar feeder gives the feeding, that is continuously inserts the raw material for machining operations. So as the auto bar feed starts feeding the machine bar through the collet, it is first step in any of the operations that correct length of the bar stock should be there for machining operation. Thus, it is very important to stop the bar feeding at an accurate location, and this is done by the bar stop that is mounted on the first point of the hexagonal turret. So when bar feeding starts on the opposite end on the turret, bar stop is in position so that as soon as bar reaches the bar stop location, the collet is stopped, or basically bar is restricted to move any further by the bar stop, and we can close the collet manually. Okay, this is the first step. Second step that is required to be used is the turning operation. Okay, so turning operation is carried out on this face. Turning operation is carried out on this face. This face is turned, and through length this face is turned. Okay, this is what we have done in our previous lecture, and tried to understand various operations. What was the second operation? The second operation in the tool was the spot facing, that is in the point number 3 of the turret, that is face 3 of the turret, holds a spot facing drill attachment which creates a spot facing drilling operation and supports the bar stock. The fourth operation is done by the forming tool to make this shape, to make this shape on the job. That is, it is a combination of two operations using a form tool. One, a small taper is generated. Another, a turned face is also generated. And the tool is mounted on the rear tool post. Okay. Now, operation number 1, stop. Operation number 2, turning. Operation number 3, spot facing. Operation number 5, forming tool on the rear tool post. So, we have used 3 turret faces, 1 rear tool post tool. Now, 4th turret face is having a drill that is mounted and a drilling operation for through drill of this job is done. That is, 4th turret face has a drill and it is being drilled through. Okay, so 5th operation on the turret face is chamfer operation or the thread cutting, that is tapping operation. If it is a threaded part, then there will be a tap in the mounted on the face of the turret. And the 6th operation, that is 6th tool on the face of the turret, would be the chamfering tool, and chamfering operation is done on the other face end. And last tool that is used is the cutoff tool. Either you can use it on the front tool post, or you can have it on the 6th of the turret part. Okay, so total number of operations that are considered for this case are 1 stop, 2 number turning operation, 3 number spot facing operation, 4th number form tool forming operation, wherein taper as well as turning both are done by the form tool at simultaneous points. 5th is the drilling operation, and 6th is the chamfering operation. Okay, so these are the operations that are required to be done and are done on the given job. Today we will see how these operations can be calculated in terms of time of machining. So we have 2 elements. One is an Excel sheet I will be showing, wherein the calculations of timings are done. So this is the operation diagram. What are different operations that are being done? And third is, and next is, how the operations are planned. So as discussed, first is stop bar, second is turning, third is spot facing, fourth is forming tool operation, fifth is drilling, sixth is chamfering operation, and seventh is cutoff. Okay, so today we will discuss these 4 operations, and the timings are calculated accordingly. So we will just go back again, wherein these operations, their feed speed, feed travel speed, tool travel operation, tool travel for operation, that is in mm, and tool change turret indexing time, which is what I have kept it as a constant for simplicity. So the non-operational travel time for each tool can be calculated, and further non-operational travel time is also given to you as a constant for each operation. That means you have 5 seconds plus whatever is non-operational time. Okay, so this is what we have as a basic data for calculating the timing of machining operation. Next table, this table shows the operation time in minutes, the operation time in seconds, non-operation time in seconds, and total machining time. So if you see, it is nearly 215.88 seconds. We round it off to 216 seconds. Then the results are 3.60 seconds minutes per job. That means something which is 216 seconds. Again, if we say in 60 minutes, that is 1 hour, how many jobs are can be produced? So it comes to 16.66 when we divide the 60 minutes by 3.6 minutes, and thus the rounded off value is 16 jobs. If you remember, at the beginning of the lectures of this chapter, I have already given you the data that how many number of jobs per hour can be produced. It is 5 to 50. So this comes, this number is between 5 to 50, and thus we can understand how easily a small adoption of two mechanisms, one is turret Geneva mechanism operated, and another is feed bar mechanism along with a collet chuck, can eliminate the human intervention and the non-operation times, which were already in some minutes, 2, 3, 4, 5 minutes, have reduced to few seconds, and overall the job machining time comes down to more than 10 times reduced element. If you want, you can check it with the conventional operations and find the time. So nearly this time would be 15 to 20 minutes, and whereas we are getting on semi-automatic as 3.6 minutes. Okay, so I hope this gives you a clarity of the picture that how automats can be used successfully to prepare or to manufacture same type of job repetitively without human intervention and the effect of human skill also. Thus, the quality of job can be improved, number of jobs produced per hour can be increased, and also it gives less operators per machine. It gives the requirement, or it reduces the requirement of operators per machine. Okay, thank you.